Okay, children, now our topic we are talking about it is utility software. Okay, so I told you previous video that we have two types of software, system software and application software. System software again are categorized into two category, operating system software and utility software. So operating system software we had discussed, now utility software we will talk about. Okay, so utility software are some maintenance software. Okay, it performs maintenance task. Maintenance task in computer maintenance. What type of maintenance it does? Okay, sometime problem occurs, isn't it? When we have to save files, okay, new files I created and I'm not getting storage space. Okay, computer is showing error, space error, storage space error. Okay, so that time we have to face this type of problems. Sometime when virus comes in computer, so we have to clean that drive. Okay, if virus comes and computer creating problems, okay, so we have to format particular drive where virus is found. Okay, we have to scan whole computer system to check whether there is a virus or not. So these type of problems it happens. Okay, and to rectify all those problems, to face all those problems, no. So we use this utility software. Okay, so one by one, three utility softwares are given in your book. So we are going to discuss about those. First one is antivirus utility software. Antivirus utility software. Okay. So virus, I told you, virus is a software. Virus is a software. Okay. Virus, it's not a type of coronavirus, disease type of virus, it's not that. Computer virus is a software, okay, which causes problem in computer system. Okay, so virus, when it comes in computer, no, so a computer hardware part doesn't work properly. It creates problem in storage device also, like in hard disk. Okay, so it creates problem. Now to detect virus, okay, we need some software to detect virus, whether computer is affected with the virus, to check this. Okay, if there is if virus has come, so after scanning we can remove virus. Okay, or we have to format whole disk. Okay, sometimes we have to format, means we have to remove all software from the disk. Means there are several drive, different parts in hard disk. So sometimes A drive or B drive, whichever drive got affected, no. So that drive we have to clean. Okay, so this is called formatting. Okay, formatting a device. So when virus, so we can protect our computer from these viruses, okay, by using antivirus software. By using antivirus software, if we have this antivirus software in our computer, so this virus will not come. Okay, if I already have antivirus software in computer, so virus generally it comes from internet. Okay, main source of virus is internet. Okay, so sometimes it comes through external storage devices also, but main source is internet. Okay, so if we have this antivirus utility software, no? So it will protect our computer from the viruses. Viruses will not come into our computer. Okay. So antivirus software, it is very useful. Okay. Very useful utility software. Some examples are given in your book of antivirus software. That is Norton. This one, Norton utility software, McAfee, Quick Hill. Nowadays, Quick Hill is the popular one. Okay. Guardian is also there. Utility software. Okay, so this utility software can detect virus and can remove from the computer. Okay, so these are antivirus software. Then next is given, this is the first one. Okay, first utility software is antivirus software. Okay, virus is a software which damages computer. What is virus? Virus is a software that damages computer. Okay. So to protect computer, we use antivirus software. Okay. Clear? Antivirus software we use to protect computer, and the popular antivirus software are Norton, McAfee, and the spelling is MCAFEE. Okay, and next one is Quick Hill. Okay, so these are antivirus. This virus, antivirus software, you know, we should have in our computer system. Okay, we should install this antivirus software into our computer system. Next is backup utility software. BACK, backup. Backup software we need. Okay, if our file is damaged by any reason, okay, because of any reason, okay, if you have lost your file, so we can bring back our lost file in computer by using the backup utility software. If we have this software, backup utility software, in our computer, so this backup utility software, it creates duplicate of all the files and folders which we have created, no, into some external storage devices. Okay, wherever you want to store duplicates of file and folder software which are in hard disk, no, so what will happen if in case hard disk is crashed, okay, and files are damaged, so we can take a backup, we can use backup means those duplicate files, okay, which were created through the backup utility software. Okay, understood? Means backup utility software creates duplicate files and folders into external storage devices which can be used. Okay, duplicates file and folders which can be used if in case files got damaged. Okay, so backup utility software, this is also very useful software, because it happens, you know, some important files and folders we have stored in computer and that been lost, so will create problem. Okay, we don't want lose our files. Okay, important files we never want to lose, but mishap, if any mishap occurs and we lost our files, so through this backup utility software, no, we can get those back. Okay, those files back to computer system. Okay, so backup utility software. Next is type of utility software. It creates duplicate. What does it create? Duplicate copy of files and folders. File and duplicate copy of file and folders. Isn't it? Where does it create? It creates these files and folders into external storage devices. Okay, external storage devices. So it can be a pen drive, it can be a CD, DVD, okay, memory card, wherever you want to store. So backup. Clear? Backup utility software. Next is given disk defragmentation. This is done. Now, disk defragmentation software. Okay. What is defragmentation? Okay. Fragmentation. First of all, we will see fragmentation. Fragmentation is the state of storage device. Okay. Where files which we have stored, okay, stored in computer. Suppose, see, this is your hard disk. Suppose it's your hard disk and file which we have stored, okay, there are several memory space. We have several memory space here, okay. What is it? Suppose it's a hard disk memory, okay. And in these memory spaces, we save our file. But when we are saving a file, F1, okay, if some part it is stored here, some part it is this and some part here. Okay. Then F2 it is here, then F2 some parts in other memory space. Okay. So what happens now? When we are going to create our next file, okay. So maybe computer will show that there is a memory space, storage space problem. Okay, storage space problem. It means next file which we are creating, no? So to store that file, sufficient space is not there. Okay, so means a computer, it's not getting sufficient space to store the file. Okay, because F1, no? It is broken into pieces. It is broken into pieces and stored different parts of hard disk. Like that, F2 is also stored in different parts. Giving you some example of F1 and F2. Its pieces are stored in different parts of hard disk. And now when I am going to create a new file, so computer is showing that sufficient storage space is not there. Means storage space is running out. Sometimes this error comes, okay, when we are going to save a new file. Okay, so this is the situation of fragmentation. The situation is called fragmentation. Here it is written in your book. Fragmentation occurs when a file is broken into pieces while it gets saved on the hard disk. Okay, so in that case, if it happens, so we use disk defragmentation software. This is another utility software. It is like cleaning agent of computer. It picks up all the pieces of file that are separated across. Okay. Now what it will do? This disk defragmentation. Now it will do like this. F1. It will put F1 here only. Then this F1 here. this F2 now will we will get place here, and this F1 again will take its place here. Okay, so all F1 it will arrange like this. All the pieces which were scattered, no, it will bring them back into their proper places. Okay, and then you see these memory space are free now. Okay, so new file, whichever new file we are creating now, will be stored here. Understood? So sufficient space. Now computer will get sufficient space to store file. Okay, clear? So fragmentation is a situation, it happens when files different parts get stored into different parts of hard disk, and to store a new file we don't get proper space. Okay, so this defragmentation utility software picks up all the pieces of file that are spread across the hard disk and put them back together again at one place.
Gracias.